It's the Montreal Just for Laughs Comedy Festival. Kevin Hart presents LOL at JFL.
I like Obama up here. I thought when Obama won the presidency that, you know, we was going to have it a little easier in America. I was wrong. They shooting more black people now than ever before. They shot so many black people 1 month. I was like, damn, where George Bush at? Because they used to give us a warning shot when Bush was president. They was nice enough to do that. Now they don't give a damn. They just out there loose-handed and cut that music down. Boom, 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 boom. You saw that stop sign? Boom, boom. They don't care. They used to at least look for a legitimate reason. Now they don't care at all. I thought when Obama won, I was going to be able to walk down the street and move into the biggest white person house on my block and say, you saw the news, this mine now. This belongs to me. Didn't work that way. Pretty much nothing changed. I think they're making up issues now to talk about. Right now in America, they're real big on this transgender bathroom thing. Now, they called me to poll me about it. They should have a little checklist on the thing that say, I ain't in the mood for that shit right now. You know what I'm talking about? You say, do you support that or not support it? Or are you not in the mood for that shit right now? And I'm on the list of not in the mood for that shit right now. I don't feel like arguing about bathroom. Where they been peeing at? Somebody tell me that. Does anybody know? Ain't they been using the bathroom? I tell you what, no more bathrooms for nobody. Shut all the bathrooms down. Pee before you leave the house. Sick of all these fake fights about bathrooms and where you gonna pee at. Pee before you leave home or pee on yourself. Gay marriage is legal in the United States now. That's good. I was pro-gay marriage, believe it or not, even though a bunch of gay people got into it with me on Twitter and started boycotting my shows and Now let me back up, because, you know, they got a very powerful lobby in the States. I don't have no problem with gay people at all. I'm actually pro-gay marriage. As a matter of fact, some of my best friends are going to hell, so I don't judge gay people. I'm not judging. They got mad at me about a joke I told about Frank Ocean, who was an R&B singer that came out the closet 3-4 years ago. But I told a little tongue-in-cheek Twitter joke about him, and one of y'all messy must have went back and told him. He not even on Twitter, but somebody must have showed him. He got mad at me and stuff, and he cornered me backstage at the Staples Center, too. Some of his fruity friends, so I had to apologize to him. I went ahead and apologized, too, because I was by myself, and you don't want to get jumped by them, because once you get jumped by them, that go on your record. You know what I'm saying? You're going to be always Robert Powell that got beat up by the Fruity Bam Bams or whatever they call it. And you can't win the fight, because once all of them start doing that windmill, then that's your ass. You can't dodge all them licks. I tweeted a simple joke. All I said was, I personally don't think Frank Ocean is gay, because all of the gay people that I know how to sing. Well, that's how he felt about it. And I stand by that joke. He don't sound that good to me. You know what I'm saying? That, and he done got lazy since he came out of the closet. He came out of the closet 4 years ago. Where the music at? Sheesh. Getting penis made him lazy. It did. No wonder my sister don't clean up that much. Who started this where you had to like everybody? You know what I'm saying? It's this thing in America where they want everybody to get along. I'm not with that. It's a group of people I don't like. Be honest with you, and I don't mind telling y'all who they are either. Let me make sure ain't none of them here first. I personally, me myself, I don't with albinos. I don't like albinos. They scare the out of me. I think they eat their babies. They sleep in a tub full of scissors. I don't like albinos. I hate albinos. I hate God for making albinos. I do not with no albinos. Have you seen them? They look like vampire people. They scare me. I don't know why God sent them people back here looking like that, but it's clearly a warning. I don't know what for. Damn, God forsake them people. Then he smited them. I don't know why he forsook them people like that, but he forsook the shit out of them. I was in Walmart about 2 o'clock in the morning, and an albino came on my row. I damn near tore that buggy up trying to get from around there. They scare me. They do. But that don't mean I want them all to go back to Albania or wherever the albinos come from. It just means I don't want to hang out with them. I don't want my kids going to school with them. It's simple. Keep them albinos over there. Before I go, I was in the back watching the news a few minutes ago, and Pat Houston, who is Whitney Houston's sister-in-law and manager, then slipped and fell getting out of the tub and broke her hip. With his Whitney Houston's sister, Pat Houston, then slipped and fell getting out the tub and broke her hip. Now, my question is, at what point do we just take all the tubs out the Whitney Houston household since they don't know how to use them? This is the third one. Damn, who off Poseidon? Why are y'all still using tubs at this point? That's how we lost Whitney and Bobby Christina. And now you still lollygagging around tubs? They make stand-up showers. Take a shower. A whole bath or something. Dude, don't go in the tub. They don't believe water wet. Still taking, damn, they should have got rid of all the tubs when they went in the bathroom and found Whitney in the tub waiting to exhale. You know what I'm saying? That one, that's too far. Too soon, it's been years. Fine. This joke's gonna get worse in a few seconds, so. Jesus Christ, get rid of all the tubs. Everybody in that family's getting in trouble in the bathroom. You don't need bathrooms. Just take a stand-up shower and be through. Poor Bobby Christina, the daughter, I felt really sorry for her, because she ain't stand a chance under that water. She didn't. In order for you to be underwater that long and hold your breath, you gotta be able to close your mouth. And she couldn't close her mouth because her gap stuck out so far, that water probably shot in there like a Katrina levee had went down, swoosh. She probably wasn't down there but 14, 15 seconds before it was over with. And boom, she saw mama. And that's what she get, because she had no business with no tub. Hell, Bobby Christina needed a tub in her house like Anne Frank needed a drum set. The Anne Frank joke for the people that went to school. The rest of y'all can Google that when this is over with. That's my time. Y'all, I'm Rob Powell. Thank y'all so much for having me. See y'all later.